Colossus status. Start on antibiotics with a view to a lab colleague tomorrow.
You want to admit her now?
Yeah, I'll send a house surgeon down.
Sweet. I'll just go tell Miss Tuttle.
I know the surgical ward is chocker, but we are going to need another bent.
I'll see if I can find something.
Your hunch was wrong, by the way. Well, the DHB haven't appointed a new CEO.
No, Chris told me.
I wonder if they offered him the job.
I think everything's still pretty much up in the air.
He said he'd make sure that I wasn't left on my own after yesterday. But so far, he hasn't shown his face in the unit. I'm starting to get worried.
About your day's workload?
About Chris. He's a brilliant surgeon. He was always so driven. There's nothing wrong with him, is there?
Of course not.
No. I suppose you would say that. You are his wife. You have to protect his reputation. But if he does have some form of health issue, I'd really like to know. At least I'd understand what's happening.
Chris does not have a health issue. He's fighting fit.
You sure about that?
Apart from a minor eye problem, he hasn't had a sick day all year.
Eye problem? Yeah, it must have knocked him about. Wouldn't he?
It was nothing. He had some treatment, took some time to recover. It's completely behind him. The only reason he's not in surgery is because he's busy upstairs.
You'd know.
That's right, I would. I'll find you that bed.
What do you think you're doing?
I'm on my break.
Which finished 15 minutes ago.
Well, Katie's a post-op patient. I'd be checking on her now anyway, so...
Well, what about your other patients? How many of them have you checked on?
You know I was up half the night.
You're a charge nurse. I need you in better shape than this. Get your things together, go home and get some rest.
I'm fine.
I seriously disagree. You're overtired and distracted. That's fertile ground for mistakes. Go home.
I'm rusted on.
Yeah, well, I'll cover the rest of your shift.
I don't want to go home.
This isn't negotiable.
I was right. Maya is so clucky.
She'd have to be to spend all night in HDU.
And Katie is gorgeous. I don't know how any nurse can help but fall in love with her.
We have to help it. We get babies coming through all the time.
We?
I might be wiping down bars, but I am still a trained nurse.
Who's opted for a total career change? If your head's not in it, you're not going to go far.
I hope you've got another job going. I'm fed up.
Why? What's happened?
Brenda sent me home. She reckons I'm overtired and useless.
You did stay up all night. Did you think she wouldn't notice the bags under your eyes?
I haven't got bags. I slept on a gurney. I'm as fresh as you are.
Hey, how's Katie?
She was fine when I left, but she'll fret when I don't come back. She's used to me.
Do you want a coffee and something decent to eat?
Yeah, thanks.
Okay. A menu and a flat white too, please. So, now, I want to know where this bossy Brenda thinks she's coming from.
Hey, how's it going?
Better than yesterday. Worse than it should be.
Still no help from Chris, huh?
No, he's talking the talk, but nope. He's still on my own.
So weird. He's usually such a theatre junkie.
It's enough to make you wonder if he's having problems again. You know, with his vision.
You heard about that?
Tony told me. Well, she says that he's fully recovered, but if his eyes are playing up...
What do you think, Brenda?
Absolutely not. If Chris's eye problem had been ongoing or likely to recur, he'd have never come back to surgery. I can't believe he'd even suggest it.
I'm not suggesting anything. Chris is AWOL from theatre. I'm simply trying to figure out why.
Maybe it's a confidence thing. He has lost a couple of patients recently, that Barry Walters.
Oh, please. Mortality is an occupational hazard. We all have to deal with it.
So what do you think is going on?
I think Chris is a gifted surgeon. And if he's leaving you with a large caseload, it's because he trusts your abilities. I think you should be flattered.
I am. But that doesn't make me able to do the work of two surgeons. Now, I know that Chris is busy upstairs, but I am simply trying to understand why he won't make any time to give me a hand.
Did you really tell Justine about Chris's eye problem?
I mean, pass, am I?
She's blabbing it all over the place, insinuating he's not in theatre because there's something wrong with him.
I said the opposite.
So did I. But you know what rumours are like. Once they're out, you can't stop them. I don't know what Justine's thinking.
I do. She's trying to shake people's confidence in Chris.
But if they don't trust him, they won't let him operate. I mean, that's not going to ease her caseload.
Unless it forces the DHB's hand, makes them hire another consultant, which pushes her to HOD.
Oh, she couldn't be that devious.
This is Justine Jones we're talking about. She shafted Chris before.
But Chris would be devastated to lose a surgical unit, especially to her.
Strictly between us, he's considering giving it up anyway.
You're joking.
Well, the DHB's pressuring him to become permanent CEO. He can't do both jobs.
But he's a brilliant surgeon. It's a crying shame if he stops operating.
If his reputation takes a dive, he'll feel like he has no choice.
Oh, this is unbelievable. He's got to tell the DHB to get stuffed and put Justine in her place.
I've tried to say that. He won't listen.
I'll try again. He's twice the surgeon that piece of work will ever be. He's got to get back in there and remind people of that before she does any more damage.
Cheers, darling.
I spent my break with Katie and lost track of time. Big deal.
You've worked through heaps of your breaks, and no one complained about that.
And I didn't make a mistake.
But that's what Brenda was trying to avoid, Maya. She was looking out for you.
She was pulling rank.
No, she so does that. But you're right. If you didn't stuff up, she had no grounds to send you home. She'd go and talk to Tony.
And who's she going to believe, me or her two, I say?
Depends how you front up. Have another coffee, splash some cold water on your face. You'll probably pass a bright-eyed incapable. It's got to be worth it.
Tons. You need it at the bar.
Can you do it? That guy gives me the creeps.
You'll manage.
Don't go running to Tony. You'll only make things worse.
Yvonne, Maya has been treated unfairly.
But she has been given the day off. They haven't even docked her pay. Katie will still be there in the morning. Get some rest.
Katie needs continuity of care. She'll think she's been abandoned again.
I know.
I don't want to make a fuss. I just want to go to work. I know what Brenda will say if I show my face again.
Unless...
We've got more surgical patients than beds, so I've shifted Ms. Nartai and Mrs. Means to the orthopaedic ward as outliers.
So, that leaves us with a full house.
My day has turned to custard. I'm never going to finish this theatre list.
How far behind are we?
Well, you're going to have to cross off the last two cases. I'll do them in the morning.
Which means cancelling two of tomorrow's electives.
It's not like I have a choice, Tony. I am running this department single-handedly.
Brenda, could you make those schedule changes, please?
No problem.
Where do you get off undermining Chris like that?
Undermining? I'm not...
First, you cast doubts on his fitness to operate, and then you make it sound like he's deliberately dodging his responsibilities. Do you really think that's the way to get ahead?
I have no idea what you're talking about. I am simply trying to keep my head above water and...
By pushing Chris under. Well, get this, it's not going to happen. I'm on to you, Justine, and pretty soon, Chris will be too. You won't get what you want this time.